It is true that size matters in this case. This picture shows a comparison of our old existing robot in this payload series and our new KR IONTEC robots. And you can see that even though both the payload it can handle and the reach of the IONTEC is a bit better than for the old robots, it's significantly slimmer in all dimensions. That means that it also gets into tight areas much better than the old one. Now, the IONTEC series actually consists of 7 models. There is the smallest robot, which has a reach of 2,100 millimeters, and is available in 3 different payloads, 30, 50, and 70 kilos. Then there is the KR50 for 50 kilos with a reach of 2,500 millimeters. And the KR20 with a reach of 3,100 millimeters and a payload of 20 kilos. Then there are also 2 sub-variants, the 70 kilos and the 50 kilos in foundry version, which are specifically made for harsher environments. The interesting part here is if we look at the 2,100 millimeter robot, you could actually buy the 30 kilo robot, and if you then later on for some reason require higher payloads, it could actually be refitted to match the 50 or 70 kilo payload by just exchanging the motors. So this gives you a bit of a flexibility when installing these robots as well. And speaking of this, what we are going to focus on here today is not all the feature, every feature of the KRs, but we are going to look at what I just mentioned, the flexibility in the life cycle of this robot, the performance improvements that it's gotten compared to the old product series, and equally important but often forgotten, the cost of ownership during the robot's lifetime. So if we start with what we call the flexibility of the robots, if we can see the working envelope of the robot compared to the KR60, it's a bit more agile, if we so to speak. The reach is marginally better. You see the striked areas are the areas where the old KR60 cannot reach. It's significantly better close to the robot itself, the robot base itself, and very much so when working below its own level. That means that the new IONTEC does not have a special version for shelf mounting, but it's the same robot regardless of it's mounted on the floor or on the shelf. Less variants is in many ways easier to handle for everyone involved. As I mentioned, it's the same version regardless of shelf mounting or not. And one new feature for the IONTEC is that it's only one version regardless of how you wish to mount the robot. Floor, ceiling, wall, or inclined. You can install it at any angle you like, and it's still always the same version of the program. You tell the robot during configuration at what angle it's mounted, but it's freely mounted in any angle. If we look a little bit closer, we will find that from axis 3 and onwards, it's IP67, which means that it could actually be immersed in water, for example. And the axles 1 and 2 are IP65. All motors are covered, which protects them from dust and strikes. There is, as I mentioned earlier, a foundry option for the warm or harsher environments. But even with a basic version, or standard version if you like, the temperature span allowed is increased from 0 to 55 degrees centigrade. And one other feature is that the robot base is hollow shafted. That means that you can do the energy supply centrally and get a neater and nicer installation for your application. So thanks to these flexible possibilities with a robot, we only need 7 models to cover all application needs compared to on the KR60 side. What do you say, Andreas? We had quite a few variants. I don't even know how many we had. No, but significantly more anyway. And that means, of course, both for us and you, lower costs and shorter delivery times with fewer variants. And less risk of making a mistake when you choose the robot. It's easier to choose the correct robot for the correct application. Now, also the performance has, of course, been a little bit increased compared to the old series of the robots. So there is an increased axis and acceleration of all axes. Before I go on, we just got a question from Martin, where he wonders if there is a version for below 0 degrees. Not yet. We have a few robots which we call Arctic variants, which are for below 0 degrees, but the IONTEC is currently not planned for that. This may change in the future or the coming years, but as far as I know of, I don't think so, but I'll have to double check it and get back to you on that. So the increased axis speed and acceleration gives us a better dynamic and possibility to reduce cycle time. And also the fact that this robot weighs 20% less than a KR60 gives us, of course, an easier installation and everything about this, but it also affects the path accuracy and the position accuracy. That means since the dynamic forces are slightly less than. The drives and gearboxes has been changed compared to the old, which noticeably reduces the noise level from the robot, resulting in a better working environment for operators and so on. And as I mentioned, the drive technology is also optimized from an energy usage system. That means that we actually use less energy for the same movements than compared to the KR60. And as I've already mentioned, the robot itself is much slimmer than the old one, which means that it's more agile. It can easier be used in very tight applications, in compact cells, and so on. For those of you who have used KUKA robots before, you know that, for example, for the KR60, there was a high accuracy model of the robot, which was these robot variants in themselves have disappeared, but the solutions still exist, but they now exist in forms of software applications instead. There are actually 3 modes to use together with a robot, if you like. One is called a path mode, typically where what you would find in a gluing or a welding application and so on. A performance mode, which is the standard mode, basically with the high dynamics. And then there's a dynamic mode, which is actually used to achieve higher speeds and reduce the cycle time. Now, if we combine the path mode with position accuracy and measurement, that is basically what you got from the high accuracy version of the KR60. But instead of having a specific robot for this, it's now a software add-on which replaces the hardware change. That also means that you could re-improve your robot by using the software. So you don't have to, you're not stuck in a corner if you buy one robot here. And as I mentioned just before, there is also the dynamic mode, which is used to optimize your cycle times. And again, this is only covered by 7 models, and better performance in each aspect allows you to do more complex tasks and faster with shorter cycle times. If we then look at the total cost of ownership, the IONTEC has been developed with special attention to the cost of ownership. Because much like an electrical motor, where it's said that during the total lifetime of electrical motor, the investment only stands for 3%. The rest is cost of electricity and cost of maintenance and so on. This applies to some degree also to a robot. And one big improvement for these robots is the mean time between failures, which is actually gone up to 400,000 hours. There's significantly less parts in these robots, and that means less spare parts as well. And we do have a 25-year spare part availability guarantee for these robots. Also, the maintenance costs has been lowered significantly. The only thing that's actually required from it is an oil change every 20,000 hours. The wrist concepts are totally without belts and shafts, so there are no belts and moving parts that needs to be replaced on a regular basis. And as I mentioned earlier, the energy consumption has fallen quite significantly, and this could actually be seen in the following, where you see that an IDA cycle where we've compared the IONTEC with the KR60, you see that it's quite a lot lower energy usage for one cycle. And while we're doing these comparisons, you can see the maintenance time. Since there are less operations to do in the maintenance, of course, the time required to do it falls quite a bit. And it's also important to point out that there is only an oil change to do. There is no internal greasing, which means that is also shortens the time to do service on your robots. Sven asks if you have any average mean time between failure numbers on KUKA robots. I don't think we have a mean time, but there are available mean time between for each model. Or do you have any other information on that, Andreas? Andreas is in parallel looking for it, and we'll see if he can find it for you in that case. So, as I mentioned, the investment cost of the robot is only a part of the total cost of ownership for the robot. So this is, of course, very important for the user of the robot, the end user of the robot. So make sure that this is part of the information you take to our customers, that this is a new concept from KUKA that brings down the cost of ownership significantly. just summarizing a little bit about the robots, these are some of the highlights we've already mentioned. A significantly lower sound from the gearboxes. A reduction of weight. A few things I haven't mentioned. Of course, there are forklift pockets available. It's not delivered with the forklift pockets. Here we got something from Andreas. He said that the average mean time is 400,000 hours for the new series of robots. The older ones are shorter. So that goes also for the Cybertech robot, as far as I know, actually 400. That's from the... yeah, but I think the Cybertech has 400,000 as well. Yeah, and the Quantec also, yeah. And as we mentioned before, it's one robot regardless of how you wish to mount it. It's the same robot in each case. The IONTEC is, of course, supplied with the KRC4 at the moment and the software 8.6, the Smart, our SmartPad 2, and Work Visual. It will be available with our new KRC5, the new robot controller, during this year. And we will talk about the KRC5 on a separate webinar, because we are also looking forward to and the new system software 8.7. So watch our webinars on these topics later on. Of course, as before, the robots can be ordered with pre-installed energy supply kits of the typical variants you're used to, from either empty hoses or different combinations of wiring inside them. That could be for control, for profit bus, energy supplies, air and ground, for example, which are then placed on arm 3 like this, as the picture shows. And of course, there's also linear tracks available or booster frames directly from us as well for this robot. And all the software add-ons that's available for the complete robot program, needless to say.